You seem to really be taking on Jeb Bush in particular in your campaign appearances. Why is that?
I don't mean to, and I've been told that by others. I was actually told that by my wife, and I don't mean to, because I think he's a nice person. I watch him. I think he's a nice person. And I actually felt bad because I hit him very hard one day, and I said, why am I hitting him so hard?
His approach to you seems to be not taking you seriously, his campaign. Not taking you seriously.
Trust me, he takes me seriously.
You think so? Okay, I was going to say, what is your message
to
Jeb Bush?
We have been contacted. My message is, I think he's a wonderful person. I look forward to seeing him.
But in terms of him not taking you seriously, what do you say?
Oh, I you know he takes me seriously. And his people have, believe me, he takes me seriously.
Why do you say that?
Because they call.
What do they say?
What would you think?
Stop attacking Jeb?
You know what? They take me so seriously. And they do call. And they write. And just believe me, they take me very seriously.
Okay.
But with all of that being said, I really think he's a nice man. I think he's a wonderful man. I don't know if I want him negotiating with ISIS. I think Trump will do a lot better. You think so too, but you're not going to say it.
Well, I don't know anybody's going to negotiate with ISIS.
Well, you could bring them to a point. Look, the whole ISIS thing has to be ended. It's got to be stopped. We have to stop that. What's going on over there is incredible.
Let me ask about the other side of the aisle, Hillary Clinton. Okay. I was surprised to read that Hillary actually went to your wedding.
She did.
She went to your wedding. And I know you've contributed to her campaigns in the past. You've said that her husband is the best post-Reagan president.
Well, I can't go with Bush. And Senior Bush, I really liked, but read my lips, I couldn't stand it.
Are you still in touch with the Clintons?
No, not. Not at all, actually, no.
Are you worried at all that somebody who has given money to Hillary, she was at your wedding?
No, I give money to everybody.
But that Republican voters in Iowa, New Hampshire, South Carolina might be concerned about that?
No, in fact, a lot of people like it. You know, we have gridlock in Washington. For instance, I've helped Nancy Pelosi, I've helped Reid, I'm a business.
Right, you gave money to Reid and
Jake,
Pelosi to help recapture Congress in 2006.
I'm a business. You know, I was in business, I built a great company. They always treated me nicely. We need that in Washington. We have total gridlock.
So you will argue to voters, yes, I gave money to Reid and Pelosi to help recapture Congress, but this is what we need, more bipartisan
spirit.
I'm
a conservative Republican. I'm a very conservative person, actually. But I get along with everybody. I would be more successful in beating Hillary, assuming that she gets it, which I think she probably will, although...
Who knows?
Who knows? I mean, if you go back... few years, she was going to get it before Obama came along.
Sure.
That was a done deal.
But you think Bernie Sanders can beat her?
Well, he's making a lot of progress. You know, you would have said, and I've watched him, and, you know, I've seen his crowds. I get crowds that are fantastic, too. He's got that. I mean, he's got a lot of people going to see him. Do I think so? No, I don't think so. But, you know, you've been in this world a long time.
Absolutely.
Stranger things have happened.
Some people look at you running for president and say, this is just about ego. It's just about getting his brand out there. What's your message to those people?
My message is that they're wrong. It's something that I've looked at over the years. I looked at it very seriously, as you know, 4 years ago. I've been thinking about it very seriously over the last period of time. And I've decided I'm going to do it.
And, Jake, and you're in it to win it. You're serious.
I'm in it to win it. Look, I give up a lot. I give up hundreds of millions of dollars in deals and potential, you know, things that I do. In all fairness, I don't want it to sound trivial, NBC renewed The Apprentice because we had a great season last season. And they would love me not to be doing this, I will tell you right now. I mean, the top people come to my office and they say, please do this. I'm not doing it because of this. I can't do it. I'm not allowed to do it. Essentially, legally, I'm not allowed to do it. But The Apprentice, I give up The Apprentice. These politicians, Jake, I see them all the time. I mean, I'm with them now. They run, they lose, they win. All they do is run. They don't lose anything. They help themselves. I'm giving up hundreds of millions of dollars. But forget about what it costs. That's the peanuts. The peanuts, the cheapest part, is what it costs to do it. I'm giving up hundreds of millions of dollars to do this. I'm giving up a primetime television show. I'm giving that up to do this. I'm a little blunt, but...
Just a little.
But you know what? Maybe that's what we need. We have to take it back. We have to take our country back. We've lost our jobs. We've lost our money. We're a third world nation, and we're a debtor nation at the same time. You need somebody with the kind of thinking. I built a great company. I have some of the great assets of the world. And I talk about that only from the center, not bragging. I talk about it because that's the mentality. that this country needs. We need that mentality now, and we need it fast.
Donald Trump, thank you so much for spending time with us.